happen at this. Trying to remake my room here because it's a mess, and I'm like kind of oversaying tonight. I got too excited on some areas there. I should never have jumped into Suicedo. I'm way out of it. I haven't done it for a long time, and it needs a lot of emotion for that pounce. I didn't. I was wrong in doing that because I'm doing the Kwando and Vol at the same time, and I'm also doing Resanft, and I'm doing that other one that Triangular Rice Spiegarvi, and the other one I'm learning is the Mo Sourre Tavla, that one, the French one, which is very good. I'm in the learning process of the lyrics, the first of it. Mon cœur. Ça ouvre ta voix comme se ouvrent les fleurs. Tant rien. Un baiser de l'horreur. And then later on after that, mais au monde, bien aimé. So yeah, it's got a lot of fun. But I just now found, like, it's like a real happy box that I found. It was a little tiny bag, but it's a bag that I've had for over like 20 years, 30 years, I don't know, a long time. And it has like all this makeup in it, and it's the makeup that I had when I was the ballerina before. And so it's like, what the heck? I still have all of it. And I have like these little pencils, and I haven't used any of it, and so it's really fun to find. I found like the eyeshadows, and all of these little brushes. Like my mom, she used to give me all these little brushes, and yeah, they're probably from the squirrels or something, and they're not good, but you know, I'm not going to throw them away, and they did last a long, long time. Here they are, and so here, and I'm on my, like my 40th aria time. I think I'm on my 44th. I think I went to Exultate now. I put that out there, and it's not the greatest Exultate. It used to be lighter and fluffier, but maybe I'm just hitting too many at once, and so it takes the light and fluffy out of my voice. Then what else? You cannot believe this box of my makeup. I am so excited. I've also found, before I get into all the lipsticks, I also found this. It is, it's from a company called Zia, and it's oil-free. It's a base. It's an oil-free base. And I'm like, is it in the bottle? Yes. It is still in the bottle, barely. You have to shake it. It went hard on it, but it is an oil-free, and that's a really good one. And I don't even remember where I got it, but because there's other ones. I have this other one from France, and it just makes me break out immediately. It's like a real pancake style. That's the worst. It just made me break out. So try the oil-free. That's a way to go. And then I'm like, well, what else do I have here that makes me look like a woman? Okay, well, I have Tantria. The Violinendo is, what do we call it? Nail polish. And I have two colors. So I have my emergency nail polish. I'm a female. In the eyes of what? Any man? Of attraction state, or any woman of attraction state, is this required that I have to have the nail polish, I have to have the makeup in order to be like accepted by the larger group, therefore then I would be what? I would be assimilated, I would be admired, I would be selected as one of theirs, I would be part of their clique. Because I have nail polish on. Well, anyway, I have some pretty colors. Yeah, I'm a little bit of a bitter about the whole thing, about the having to put it all on. Okay, so then I have so many of these. I think I was like a lipstick fanatic in my life. And then maybe they aren't that many. Maybe they're just not that many to you. Maybe you have 50 or 100 different little collections of lipstick. But I have a lot. These are all my lipsticks. I have so many lipsticks. And I'm like, what the heck? These are all my lipsticks. Ridiculous. I can't even think about going through them all. But I will. Why not? Got all of those. It's like, and then some of them are really pricey. They're old ones though. And they're probably rotten, but they're still gonna be used. This one has a little box. Makes it special, has a mirror to ward off any vampires, even the self vampire. And inside I had the little Clinique style. I have a lot of the Cliniques. I use those a lot. Let's see. I can line up all my colors. I don't know. Sometimes, oh, that's a darker one. Yeah, I'm a lipstick freak. Now look at that one. I went all the way through to the bottom of it. So that was a selected one. It's really light. I wonder why that one I was wanting so much. I'm not sure. Sometimes there is a really light one that's unusual. Well, now that one is interesting also. Oh my god. And you know, the colors, the tones are just, the differences are very, very minimal. And you know, probably to most people they don't even care or notice, but yeah, it's just one shade, one tone difference, you know. Just one shade and one tone, that's all. I don't know, I always have liked the Cliniques. There's the other ones though, I use that. I'm sorry, I'm not really a Maybelline fan. I know that they had a lot of Maybellines. I use Maybelline for other things, more like their facial cleaner stuff. But I never really got into them on the makeup so much. Yeah, these are all brand new too. So I don't know what I was doing. I just have like a brand new life here with brand new Cliniques, and I'm like, well, that one. Since some of them are really, really like subdued, and I didn't even find this to cheer me up because I'm feeling a little low. Believe it or not, I'm feeling low. I can do that. I can feel low because I don't know all the words to Monko. Mon se ouvre te voir. Not yet. I'm halfway through. I learned half of them tonight. Alright. So there we go. And this is like, I guess it's like the ostrich thing, and we're not supposed to have them either. Because it's not healthy for the little animals to go and pluck and play them. With this one. It's a real bright one. I know my lighting isn't that great. You know, I'm looking for a real hot fluorescent hot pink. Most of these are really, really low-keyed. Yeah, that's another low-keyed one. Ay, ay, ay. So, what is that? Ooh. Ever so often I get across one that has like a real, like, expensive container. Which one is this? This is like a Lancome style. Oh yeah, Lancome's. Okay, that's a darker one. And I guess that expensive container, like a woman will pull that out of her purse or something, and what, you know, she gets more of that group after her because she has that coming out of her purse. Ay, 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 she's rich. Yeah. This is a problem group, huh? Okay. Oh, look at this. I found a deep chocolate vampire. Oh, good. I always need a deep chocolate vampire. You never know about that. Yeah, you gotta have that one. Very dark. Ooh. I love it. I love having that one. Okay. I swear, I was looking for the hot pink. Oh, there's a light. You see how light that is? Yeah, that's a very unusual one. These are brand new. I haven't even put my lips on them. Alright, what is this one? Another dark. Uh-oh, this one I have used. It's another dark. Okay. Ew. And what is this? Actually, this one is a little hotter, a little warmer. And then what else do I have? Oh my gosh. And then the brushes. I did find some interesting mascaras. I don't know where I got them, but I have them. Probably that, like a little department store somewhere. Here's another lipstick, that style. Yeah. You know, I never got into the purples or the grapes. I guess I've never really lived. You know, it's very exciting. Oh, she dropped her something down there. But no, really, I did. I dropped one of the lids. Okay. Really? Okay, so here we are at the... Oh my gosh! And I even have these little lipstick cases. Like, remember you put your mirror there, it's like you can do all of that as you make sure you always get your makeup on just right. Yes, yeah, that's brought to you by the Clinique people. The old days, they used to give you mirrors and you got like a little bag filled with things, with little gifts. I don't know if they do that anymore. Here's a Lancome special. Ooh, look at that, a doubler. That's what I also have here. I did talk about the brushes, didn't I? The brushes are actually the most exciting for me. Because I've even used them for art also, artwork. Eeks, it sure is work too. I was just moving some things around today and all of my art pencils went all over the floor and I'm like, well, this is no fun. This is not what I wanted to do with art. Pick up all of their pencils. Yeah, these are great. All of these little ones. Use them for your eyebrows. All of that. All of this motion under here, a little bit, the blendings, the lips, doing the highlight, and then what else? Oh, I was watching some drag queens, I don't know if I mentioned them before, but they really plaster it on there pretty good. They really go at this upper area of the brow, and they just wash it out. A lot of them, they just take it out. They don't even use this area, and they just use concealer, and then they do something wilder with their brow. So they have conceal, and then they do big conceal, and here, and then those are the extra white concealers. Then they do the regular concealer. Like a more normal color, normal color tone, and they're fast. Those guys are fast. You know, they're faster than I can even dream of being. They are quick, and they never put on their eyelashes first. They always put their eyelashes on last. That's like the last thing. So remember that in your future, because it is, because I've done it. I put them on my lashes, and I'm like, oh, and I try to dodge around them, you know, because the lashes do cheer you up right away, but it's better to do the colors of all of, you know, whatever you're doing, in all of these tones. And my way, because I have a special way, I just like my under lines. And I don't use the liquid liner. I have not gone that direction. But some people really are good at it. They're good at that artwork of it. Here's some more. Gosh dang it, all the browns. I have a lot of browns. So anyway, so this was just a new bag. I had another bag that I've been using, and I was getting bored with it. I'm like, what? I only have like 10 or 20, you know, eyeshadow colors. And so anyway, so I'm feeling kind of ridiculous. It's kind of a fun little thing to do. And then, like I said, I have these ones, these little fluffies for the blush. Anyhoots, that's all I've got. Wait, what is this? Yeah, I don't really have anything to say tonight. Just working on these Arias. Oh no, this one is a bright one. It's like a Clinique. I think it's a blush. Like a blush to use. Yeah. Oh, I don't know. So any hoots. What do I have? I have like the pencil thing. You need for that sharpener. Oh, a white one. Now I have a white pencil. Now that's good. I like to use the white from the corner of the eye out between the lines. It's just, and then sometimes you can even use it up here in the eyebrow if you want to pronounce that eyebrow even more than just a brow color, a light brow color. There you go, white. And I was always told, like, if you're doing stage makeup, to get into the, especially if you're fair haired, just to, don't forget it. Where is the dark? You get a dark blush, you get a dark eyeshadow, something at the dark, and darken this. Because we have a tendency to bald out look, you know, as soon as the light goes in. It starts to make us look bald up there. So yeah, darken that, and it really gives you the face place, you know, the place where your face lives, and before the hair, you know. So, because that's important. On the stage itself, you have to have, you know, and this is the face, and this is the hair, and this is the body, and this is the costume. Do you know what I mean? Everything has to have its own distinction, and then all of those things together make the full package, and that's what makes it just extreme. It's because you have the face, you have the hair, you have the body, you have the costume, and then you have hopefully the skill, the expertise, you have the prowess of being that performer, or that expert, that professional at, I should not say that on YouTube. I've seen some professionals, and my goodness, they don't really do very much. those ones, you know, if they put that, it's like a dot. Yeah, you don't want that dot. Anyway, so I've been having like Like I had like a mild panic. Oh, funny, yeah, mild over mild in Liesa, Liesa, mild and Liesa. Yeah, that one. Mild und Liesa. Wir lack Geld. Yeah, that one. So anyway, I learned the blasted words. I did it, but I'm still not real strong, dramatica. I'm never gonna be. Unless I am like playing with them and they're in my ear, you know, if I can hear them in my ear, then maybe I can harp into those same sounds. But on my own, I am just kind of a pansy. So I'm stepping back from the hyper dramaticas. What do we call them? We call them. Oh. They're called dramatic sopranos. So I have to step back from them and maybe be like more like a melodramatic legato, something like that, yeah. I don't know. So anyway, I'm very happy for my find. Isn't that neat? Isn't that neat to find something like this? I am pretty happy with it. So anyhow, so I've been doing my recordings. I've been telling all these people, and I made like this little foam cover. Don't laugh. But I put a little foam cover over the microphone, and it is helping because I am awfully loud, and it helps. It helps quiet it. Anyway, so the mild and Liesa, that one is. Done. And so I'm going through the list of everything. So I'm at the 44. I made the Exultate, and then I'm still wondering who's next. I'm having a fight with my Ressamt because it's so light. I have a really light and airy one. It's really light up there. But it's so light and airy that the computer doesn't like it. It makes me sound really kiddish, like young child. So, and then I tried to put reverb into it. I tried to put the back of like a church into it. None of that is working. So, not sure what I'm gonna do because that's what it's done. All of my high are turned into like a little child voice. And so it's really turned me into a forced mezzo, and I don't want to be a forced mezzo because I can sing those songs and I know they sound just fine in person. So I'm kind of mad that the computer is not translating the airy light of that Ruesamt. Yeah, that's a shame because it's a really pretty song. And then they have, and also the Vere Spiegarvi, I didn't think I was up for, but I don't know. I guess I'm okay at it. Condano, it's just the words there, the Condano il Fatto. I've been singing that. Well, I've sung a lot of these, you know, through my lifetime, the last 15 years, ever so often, sporadically, maybe I'll sing Vere, but I never really knew the words. And I always sang along, and so now when I'm doing it on my own, it's just really like putting it in another place, isn't it? It just puts it in another place. I am a little bit proud of myself that I am able to sing it by myself. Of course, I've got to over 40 now, but like I said, I'm still missing like 30 arias that, Patria Mia. Yeah, I can't find instrumentals for that I like. Pace Pace, that one, I can't find instrumentals I like. I mean, I'm just can't even believe I found Tacea la Notte Placida. I cannot believe it that I got that one through. And then I had this other one, this, gosh, what is it? Ad'amor Soglia Rose. Now that one was always tough for me, but I did it anyway. So that was always one of my hard ones. And I can sing Folie, you know, the whole Folie ending of Al Forse, I can do it. I just haven't found a good, happy, where she says, amore. I love that part. Amore. She's saying amore and he's singing. She says, amore. I love that part also. But I have it, but they turned it into a car commercial. Remember? They and then it kind of turned me off the whole thing. I didn't want to do the car commercial. So anyway, what else is there to say? My exaltate is a little heavy. And why is it heavy? I don't know. Actually, I don't know. Like when I'm speaking into the microphone, it likes to go dong, 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 like pound at it. It likes to, like the heavier frequencies, which are between the 100 and the 500, those ones are like in the lower, in your bass range. For some reason, the computer is picking them up and making them louder than like my highs. So it's just taking the lows and making them louder, and it's taking my highs and making them smaller, you know. So it's very unbalanced, and because it's making them so loud that it makes like a pound, so it's not enjoyable. Makes a pounding sound, and because the ears don't want to hear, you know, they don't want to hear like that. They don't want to hear that. They want to hear, you know, everything even, in a way. You know, they want to hear the volume in an even. But yeah, it's like a spike. It's like a bass spike, if that makes any sense. And I've gone through and I fixed it. I've taken that audacity and I've lowered it. I've used the equalizers and I've done this and I've done that. It's still there, so I don't know. I don't know. Maybe some things you just can't change. Anyhoots. What else? Maybe it was just my excitement a little too. I guess I could have gotten excited and been a little heavy. I could blame it all on this trying to be dramatic a soprano, because when they go into that type of voice, when you go into that training and the type of self, when you go into that, all of the other arias get all like also. So you have like to like scale them back and say no, I don't want you to be such a heavy, you know, I don't want you to be like that. Yeah, so they start to have so I have to run away from that direction, from the Wagner, and then run back to doing something really light. I love the Trust Lost song, also from the from Mozart, but I cannot find its instrumental. That's a very good one. That's a really good one. What else do I have pending? I had, I don't know, Lascia Ciopangia, that one? Maybe. I haven't sung that one for a long, long time. And even, you know, a lot of these I haven't sung for a long, long time at all. And like the Moncourt with the French one, maybe I've sung only in France a little bit, and then I sang it maybe once in California, so I haven't sung it at all, and so I started singing it again. It's really lovely though. It has a nice flow. And then what else? Oh my gosh, I'm tired. I'm just tired. It's a lot of makeup. And no, I'm not saving the world tonight. Not, I'm sorry. What else is there? I need my fans. Yeah, no, I had a lot of those in my photos of fans. Eeks. Let's see. What else did I find here? Well, I did find some other things, but I won't tell you everything that I found. too exciting. Okay, well, anyhoots, that's all. That was Teresa Rosa Teresa. Yes, it's what? I'm at the thinking about doing a good Paquita or something, or not Paquita, but that Don Q, where she just takes that fan and whacks it. It's so fun, isn't it? Ballet is so fun, opera is so fun, but then it is so much work that it is like being a nun, and well, I guess you could call me one already, and so that's it, yeah, so, anyhoot. What is this? Oh, well, I've gotten so fat recently, I can't stand it. I just can't stand it. I'm gonna have to lose weight, and I've been making cookies. Actually, no cookies. I switched from cookies into cake, and so now I'm making cake. You know, it's got honey, it's got oil, it's got the flax, the ground flax, it's got the cocoa, and it's got flour, and I've added in that it's almond milk. Stir, stir, stir it all together. Maybe some baking soda, I don't know. Baking powder. And that's it. And you could add vanilla, but oh my gosh, I've been eating it for like 2 weeks of like, oh, I ran out of the cake, and so I make some more, and then run out and make some more. And so it's like a never, never ending supply of cake, chocolate cake. And, oh, I forgot, I also add the chocolate chips into the cake. And that makes it have, like, that decadent extra goo in it. So you have the chocolate cake part, and then you bite into it, and then it has that melted possible available. So it's really, really fattening. And, so yeah, anyway, it's 1 o'clock. And I'm here, thinking about the cake, how I gotta stop it, and turn it off. How do I turn that off in my brain? I don't know. The garden is fine. I have the sweet potatoes that are growing everywhere. I had no idea they grew like this. I only planted 2 sweet potatoes. But they have sprouted maybe 5 feet in every direction. So they have gone like, woo, woo. You know, it's their world. They're growing into the broccolis, they're growing into cabbages, they're growing into the zucchinis. They don't care. They're growing over through the blackberries and up across the wall a little. They are just, and they're pretty. They're pretty plants, yeah. So I like the sweet potato. If you want to fill up space like all summer long, plant the sweet potato. I swear, get that sweet potato in, and at least you'll have a plant during the summertime in these desert areas that just keep lasting. It's amazing. And also the carrots. Carrots last also. Carrots and sweet potatoes, and thus far broccoli, have been amazing. Once you get those up there and they're growing, there's nothing to stop them. So they're like a permanent decoration for the summertime. Well, it's not permanent, it's the other way. Perennial? No, the other one, the annuals. It's like, they're like annuals. So. Anyway, isn't that exciting? I found out my lipstick. Oh my gosh. I'm still missing one. I had a couple that were real hot colors and I can't find them. Anyway. Woo-woo. What was the thing I was doing? I know I'm missing some songs, some arias I haven't told you about. And I know this is like the Teresa talk, Norm's talk about stop about the arias. But I can't help it, because that's all I'm doing right now. In the Bellini range. I was gonna add Convien Partir, but I'm not gonna do that yet. I'm gonna wait until I get some other ones done. I'm having a devil of a time with Glières, the My Belle, and the regular float one. Anyway, that's all. That's all. That's where I'm at. Anywho, and I'm not doing any genealogy at the moment. I can't. I'm too tired. So I gave them out, though. I gave out like 20,000 names. I connected 20,000 names, and I and they're names that connect a whole bunch of people. So they're all royal, and so it's very exciting for them, and so. There should be a lot more of you pronouncing yourself king and queen, if you want, but I was there first. All right. Anyway, good night.